Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you all are doing well. If you are new here, my name is Nishita. I would love for you guys to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up if you like it. In today's video, I'm going to do a review and wear test of the new Beauty Blender Bounce Foundation. This has been out for a while, like probably, you know, sometime last year. But when they first came out with this foundation, they didn't have a good shade range. Like, they didn't have any shades for tan skin tones. So, which was, you know, really disappointing because the Beauty Blender itself is like one of my must-haves. Like, I cannot apply my foundation without a Beauty Blender. That's how much I love this particular sponge. So, when they came out with the foundation, I definitely wanted to try it. But since now they have expanded their shade range where you can find a good shade for tan skin tones as well, I decided to do a review on it. So in today's video, I'm gonna apply this, wear it for the rest of my day and see how it lasts. I got the shade 3.75, and this foundation comes in 40 different shades now. You get 1 fluid ounce of standard product. So the packaging of this foundation is definitely white like this, and you do get a pump with this foundation, but it's a little bit different. So when you pump out the foundation is going to land on here, so you don't have to use the back of your hand. So I'm going to do a shade swatch for you guys, so you can see how this looks on my skin. So you do this. You get that sound. So this is how you pump out the foundation. So this is the swatch of the shade 3.75. And this is the swatch on my skin. So I'm just going to use my beauty blender, like take some foundation from here and start applying it. So they claim that this is a weightless liquid whip foundation with a multi-dimensional velveteen matte finish that wears up to 24 hours. So it's supposed to give you a full coverage matte finish. It's a liquid formulation and it's for normal dry combination and oily skin types. The highlighted ingredients are, it has hyaluronic acid, which supports natural moisture and helps prep skin for a smooth canvas. And it also has white birch extract, which is supposed to soothe and brighten your skin. Coverage of this foundation is not going to be a super full one right off the bat. You can build it up and build up the coverage to a full, but right off the bat it will give you a coverage that is in between medium to full, and I'm not complaining. I like that coverage. So the finish of this foundation, when I was first applying it, it did have a slight satin finish, that velvet finish, but it has now a dried down to a matte finish. But being said that, this does not feel drying on my skin at all. In fact, it actually feels a little bit hydrating. Like, not as hydrating as a dewy foundation would feel, but still, it feels very hydrating. So far, it's very impressive. I'm not let down by this foundation. And the foundation did blend out like a dream. Now, I'm gonna go off camera, finish the rest of my makeup. When I get back, I'm gonna tell you guys how everything layered on top. And then we're gonna do the wear test. So guys, it's been 4 hours since I've had this foundation on. I applied this around 9:30. Now it's already 1:30. I did start very early today because I wanted to get, you know, filming done, because my mom's gonna visit me soon. Then I want to spend some time with her. So I am planning on pre-filming a lot. But anyways, coming back to the foundation, I think I am in love. My bronzer, blush, concealer, everything blended beautifully on top of this foundation. Had no issues whatsoever. Even after wearing this 4 hours, I still do not see any oils peeking through. The foundation, like, feels very lightweight on me. I don't feel like I have foundation on, even though it did provide me a good amount of coverage. The coverage of this foundation is perfect for me. Like, this is the coverage that I like whenever I want my skin to look really flawless. This foundation is just making my skin look really smooth. It doesn't look heavy or cakey anywhere, and it is completely transfer proof. Like, there is no transfer whatsoever, because of course this is a matte finish foundation. But being said that, this does not feel drying at all. Like, you know, I did use a setting spray because, you know, I usually use a setting spray when I finish my makeup. But even if I hadn't, I don't think this foundation would, you know, look powdery or drying on my skin. So I feel like no matter what kind of skin tone you have, this foundation will work really well. So at this 4 hour point, I am so impressed with this foundation, and this particular shade 3.75 is like a match made in heaven for my skin. I really like it. Like, even when I go in the natural light, it just looks like a perfect match. So far, I love the shade. I love the formula. I'm gonna keep this foundation on for 4 to 5 more hours and see how it holds up. But I feel like it's not gonna disappoint me. Anyways, I'm getting ahead of myself. I'll see you all at the end of my day. Hey guys, so it's been a total of what? 8.5 hours since I've had this foundation on. I did take off my lashes because they were driving me crazy. But I'm here to share my final thoughts. First, let's start off with the good things. The shade range of this foundation is really good. This foundation Feels very lightweight on my skin. It blended out beautifully. And it looks naturalish for a foundation that has almost full coverage. The finish of this foundation has to be my favorite because it has this natural matte finish and it feels very hydrating on the skin as well because of the whipped texture. So even if you have extra dry skin, you can totally use this matte foundation. But if you have normal to combination or oily skin, I think you're gonna love this. This foundation is very long wearing. It is transfer proof and you can still see my concealer and bronzer intact. And especially if you have been a subscriber of mine for a really long time and you know that I love my Lancome Long Wear foundation. I know a lot of you purchased that foundation based on my recommendation and most of you loved it. So if you're someone who liked the Lancome foundation but couldn't find a shade that matches your skin tone, this one is very similar to that. This one has 40 different shades, so you might be able to find a shade in this one. Because I like this one as much as I like the Lancome one, because it does not settle my smile lines, it does not feel drying on my skin. I really like it. I highly recommend you get a sample and try this foundation out because it's really good. Coming to the cons, the one con that I find with this foundation, before moving on to the cons, I have one more pro that I want to share with you. Especially, it's a big deal for me. This does not have any strong scent to it. I really like that fact. And moving on to the cons, the packaging, I like the idea. I like that it's unique. I like that I don't have to use the back of my hand, but it's not very hygienic because, you know, I did pump out the foundation. I took a makeup wipe and cleaned it all off, but I can still see a blob of foundation stuck right underneath the pump. I'm going to have to use a Q-tip and clean it all up, but that's just not coming off. For that reason, I don't think this packaging is very hygienic, even though I like the idea of it. And the second con is that it's not a con. I think it could happen to any foundation at this point, is that it is looking a little bit shiny in this area. When I first applied it and when I did the 4-hour check-in, I didn't see this shininess, but right now it is looking a little bit shiny. But keep in mind, I haven't done any touch-up since I applied the foundation. So that completes this review. I hope you guys found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already. Also give this video a thumbs up and I will see you all in my next one. Bye!